And Mukesh, you all know, is a very, very successful producer, having produced over 50 films in the last 20 years. He is also the current president of the Producers Guild of India.
Thank you.
For us two, entertainment always comes first. And we're talking about commercially successful entertainment. That also comes first. And so now I get to turn to Mukesh Bhatt. And we're so pleased to have you here. And there, I have a number of questions, but I'd also just like to make a comment that Hollywood Health and Society in LA has a partnership with the Writers Guild of America West and the Writers Guild of America East. And so we're working with very active, successful writers. And of course, that's what the Guild promotes. And so why would they partner with us? They would partner with a cause. We're not a cause, we're a tool. They know that we can help writers make their writing even better. And so kind of in that light, I know that you're a true leader and such an accomplished producer yourself, but also the president of the Producers Guild. And so I'm wondering, would the Producers Guild, for example, be interested in a partnership with the Third Eye to make available to all of the members of the Guild the resources we offer? So I guess that's one question. And then I'd love to hear you speak about what makes for commercially successful cinema and television.
First of all, I want to thank you for calling me for this morning for this lovely panel discussion. Being as a filmmaker, I've only made 63 films till date. 63 films, yeah, not old. And being the president of the Film Producers Guild of India, which is the largest body in the production. As you know, Aerial India makes only 1,400 movies a year. So we have a tremendous presence in terms of creating an impact in the psyche of every fifth person walking on this planet. The atmosphere in India. So we know the power of our Indian movies on the psyche of every fifth human being walking on the planet. But having said that, I would like to start by saying that the producer is not a villain. This is made to be started off by director. I always tell my creative team, which is headed by my brother, Mr. Mahesh Bhatt, is that when you talk about art and any so-called social issues, don't mess around in movies by a Picasso. That was from cheaper. Yeah. We spend crores of rupees making a movie. And me, handling that dirty part called money, has a responsibility to safeguard my investment. And so I have to understand that my office is a commercial enterprise and not a charitable enterprise. While charity is important, it's very much the need of the hour, but at the same time, I can't confuse the issues. There has to be a clear demarcation of what is commercial and what is charity. You can't mix the two. Having said that, I, as a filmmaker, know very well that cinema is nothing but extension of life. My movies connect with the real world, with the real things that happen on the streets of on the smaller streets of my country. I have to relate. My characters belong to the street. They don't belong to some other land. And I deal with the problems which my characters feel because human beings are interested in human beings. And that's what storytelling is all about. So when human beings confront problems, which is very natural in day-to-day living, whether it's diseases like cancer or mental disorders like schizophrenia or depression, I feel I make films which deal with schizophrenia. I've done films which deal with people in suicide as a producer. And I tell you, I'm not a villain. I have done it with a sense of responsibility. And I feel that's the deal of the hour. That the third eye comes with a great amount of insight to help the writers, the film community, to look at their stories to be told in the way it should be told, without sounding preachy or not sounding, you know, too documentish. It should not document it. Ultimately, our job is to entertain you. We are dream merchants. We are a distillery of human emotions. And we stand committed to it. So within those parameters, we need to operate the certain set of responsibility. Because ultimately, we all are responsible citizens. We owe it. And that there cannot be a better telling than movies. Because the movies reach the hearts and the minds of the smallest, of the most uneducated individual in the remotest part of our country. And that's the need of the hour. Books cannot reach him. Books cannot make him understand. The seminars will not help him. It's through a movie, because for a normal Indian in the streets of Banaras or Guwahati or whichever part of India, for him, going and watching an Indian movie is like eating food. It's his need, like as much as eating food is. So through your movies, if you can get interesting stories, then you can also throw some insight of what the problem of a mental disorder is. For a normal man, it's like, that person is mad. He's not mad. There are different ailments, mental ailments, which need to be addressed and awaken that kind of understanding in them. So while I feel, yes, there is a responsibility as a producers, again, with the president, I feel this is a very welcome thing that's happening, and I would give you my complete support from the Guild that we need to send whatever you need, what kind of support you need from the Guild. I assure you, you have my 100% support. Because I think that's the deal of the hour, and that's what, as individuals, as responsible citizens, we stand committed, and we should be doing it. So while it's very easy to say that the prince is always the villain, he always wants to look at entertainment, he's not as bad as you think it to be. He is also a human being, he's also a man of the family, he's also sensitive. But yes, he is concerned about his pocket. And you can't blame him for that. You know, he needs to protect his pocket, because if he doesn't, then he'll be one of the beggars standing on the street begging and asking for mercy. So having said that, I feel that it's a beautiful thing that's happening, very important thing that's happening, very responsible thing that's happening. And I would call this day a historic day, because what we can achieve through our movies is something unimaginable. And that's the deal of the year.